Hey there everyone, Flutter Mentor here, and today we're going to learn how to install a Flutter package in a very short video. It's actually quite simple, so just follow along and I'm positive you will have no difficulties whatsoever. As you can see, this is a very simple UI. It's just to show the package in action. We have a container, we have a text widget, and it's text aligned, font size 25, colors white, all super simple. And it doesn't really matter, that's not what this is about, so let's get to it. The package we're going to download is called minid, and its goal is to generate a random ID whenever you need it. So we come here over to pub.dev, and we search for minid, because I know the name of it, but then you can see the pub points, which is basically the website of evaluating how good the package is. 110 is the maximum amount. And then, of course, the popularity, which strangely is kind of low here, but honestly, I like this package. It works very well. As you can see, this is the package. I always advise you to read the README tab because it explains how to use the package and other details on it. But anyway, let's go over to the installing tab because that's what this video is about. As you can see, they actually explain to you how to install it right here on the page. But you don't have to read it. You can just watch this video and you will be fine. So what we're going to do now is copy the dependency and then paste it in our project. Now, here you gotta go to pubspec.yaml, which will be over here in this section. Don't get scared by the massive amount of text here. The green text is just comments. The only thing that matters is the orange and white text. Now, this is YAML. That's the language that is being used in this file. When it comes to semicolons and that kind of stuff, they don't use it at all. Once you get here, as you can see, there's dependencies and there's Flutter and then there's the SDK that is also Flutter, but that doesn't matter to you. You're just trying to add a new dependency. I always use this little tab underneath here that tells you the path, and that's a great way to know that everything is in its proper place. And the one dependency that is like the one you're trying to add that is always present in the project is the Cupertino icons dependency. So all you gotta do is put your mouse right here and then paste what you just copied. And as you can see, it perfectly aligns with Cupertino icons. It's two spaces ahead of the beginning. And that's exactly where it should be because dependencies is in the first space. And that's pretty much how it works here. You do double space every time you change lines. It's just the rules, okay? You have to be very careful. If anything doesn't work with a package, you're probably doing something wrong here. So always double check that everything's proper, everything's correct. And then once you're sure everything's good, you just click pub.get if you're using Android Studio, or if you're using Visual Studio Code, you can just run this command right here, flutter pub get, and it will be the same thing. So now that we've done it, let's go over to home.dart. Sometimes this warning will show up and just click get dependencies. This is most likely a bug because you already got the dependencies, but it doesn't hurt you to do it again, so just do it. Now the next step, and this is a very important step, whatever you want to use the package, you have to import it first. So usually what I do, I just type in the name of the package and the file that matters always ends in .dart. There might be a few exceptions, but usually it always ends in .dart. And now that we have imported it, we can use it. So let's do it. Let's see how this works. In fact, I'm just going to go back to the page and steal from their example tab right here, where they exemplify how to use it. So let's just take this here, copy it, go back to our project. Let's paste it here. Now, what is this? This is a final ID and it equals minid.getID. Now, this is a class and a method that are specific to the package that you just got. If you had not imported minid.dart, this would not be working. It would be broken, but you did import it. So now let's place it in our UI. Let's get rid of the string and put in the ID. And now if I hit save, there it is, a new ID. And if I save again, yeah, new ID, new ID, new ID. I think you get the point here. But this is just a package thing. Every time this method is called, it generates a new string with a new ID. So thank you to 4pet.social for this. I hope you like this package. I hope you like this video and that you learned something new. Without anything else to add, this is Flutter Mentor, and I'm out.